Hello students, today we are going to start with a new chapter. Let me write the name of the topic. It's crop production and management. Okay. So when I write this topic on the blackboard, crop production and management, the first question which comes in our mind is that what is there in this chapter, what we are supposed to study in this. So children, as you can see, the name itself suggests crop and production, like how the crops are produced, what are the different steps which we follow or has to be followed, how it has to be managed, and several terms which is used in agriculture, also several instruments which are usually used in agriculture. Now the second question which comes in our mind is that why we have to study this chapter. So just a thing which I want to clear over here, that still our country is known as agriculture based country. Around 70% of our population is still directly or indirectly joined or is linked with agriculture, and so we should know how or what are the different steps or how the crops or the food which we eat, the grains which we have at our home reaches to us. So to start with, children, actually we all eat food, right? We all eat food. Okay, now let me ask you one thing, why we eat food, what is the need of eating? Okay, and everybody knows the answer also. It is well known that we eat food for several reasons. Say for example, to get energy, okay, then maybe for growing, for growth, for like to be alive, okay, to be alive, maybe for repair of our body, for repair of our body, fifth I can take or I can say for the proper functioning of the body, proper functioning of the body. Okay, so these can be the reasons why we eat food. Okay, now first of all, to get energy. Now let me clear up with this point. Like suppose if someone makes you sit without giving food even for a day, okay, and then he gives you many things, many good things are kept in front of you, maybe like a very interesting games, maybe video game, something like that, but you won't be able to play, and you won't like rather to play. You will ask for the food. Why? Because without food we cannot have any kind of energy. Because for throwing even a small ball, we need to have energy within us. And so the first use, the first thing, first reason why we have food is to get energy. Now second is for growth. Obviously, the children who do not eat properly, they suffer from one or the other diseases, and we can call them even malnutrient, okay. That means for growth, for proper growth of the body, it is very very essential to have proper food. Now third is to be alive. Very rightly said that if you want to be alive, if you want to be in this world, if you want your existence, you need to have food. That means to be alive. Now how our body, like one or the other time we get, you know, one or the other, like maybe like small things, so cutting of the finger, cutting of the nail, cutting of the a small cut, we need to repair. In general also our cells die for having new cells in the body, for the formation of new cells, for the repair of our body, again we need to have food. Now again, if when we have food, when we have proper energy, then only the various processes of our body can takes place. Maybe respiration, maybe the other things like growth, I said, excretion, whatever, the circulation of your blood, nothing can function, nothing can go smoothly until unless we have food. Okay, so first topic is food, and my question was, why do we need to have food? So here are the answers, why we need to have food. Now second question is, from where this food comes? Okay, from where? Or I can also say, what are the sources? Okay, what are the sources of our food? Okay, whatever we eat, either we get it from plants, whatever we are eating, either it is coming from plants or animals. Okay, now when we talk about plants, everybody know, I know these are very basic things. Okay, what I can write? I can write wheat, I can write maize. Okay, no need to give more examples because we all know. Now animals, I can write meat, I can write egg. Okay, again many examples, and the best part is we all know this. Okay, but now there's a difference between the plants and animals. We all know this one also. Like plants are the one which prepare their own food, and so these are known as autotrophs. Okay, now what's the meaning of autotrophs? Those organisms which prepare their own food. Okay, so those organism which prepare their own food are known as what? Autotrophs. And in this, the example is only plants. Okay, only plants are the one who follows autotrophic mode of nutrition, and they form glucose is formed. Okay, now if I say that even animals, all the animals depend on plants, will it be correct or no? I'm saying directly or indirectly all the animals depend upon the plants. Okay, if I take the example of the cow, goat, obviously these are herbivorous animals and so these are dependent on plants. But if I take the example of the lion, tiger also, even the lions and the tigers, what they eat? They eat deer. Okay, and deer in course depends upon the plants. So the major source of the production of the food is plants. Okay, so first of all, from where we are getting food, what are the sources of getting food for us? So it can be two sources, rather it can be plants or it can be animals. When we talk about the plants, we have got plenty, n number of examples, say wheat, maize, jowar, barley, pea. Okay, many examples we have got. Even for the animals, we have got many examples, meat, egg, chicken. Okay, now, but all animals, directly or indirectly, they depend upon the plants for their food. Okay, now plants are the only organism in this universe who can prepare their own food. The preparation of food, which preparation, that means the process by which the plants make their own food, is known as photosynthesis. And how does this reaction, like how does this process takes place? In the presence of what? In the presence of like carbon dioxide, in the presence of H2O, like these things are utilized, and then sunlight, okay, and chlorophyll, and then what is being made here? Food is made. Okay, so these, and even I should write here O2. Okay, so again it is not a balanced equation, it is a skeleton equation. Like by using carbon dioxide and water in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, what is formed? glucose can be formed and oxygen is a byproduct that is removed out, which is used by us. Okay, so main thing, autotrophs, only the plants are the one which can prepare their own food. So like what has to be done, like how we can get more food, we will learn in the further topics. Now see, when we talk about the early men, okay, when we talk about the early ancient men, he used to be a wanderer. Okay, what's the meaning of wanderer? He used to lead a nomadic life. He used to live a nomadic life. Nomadic life means what? He used to feed upon raw materials like raw food, raw vegetables, okay, and he used to lead his life. Then slowly what happened, even he started growing crops. Okay, so first of all, the early man was what? He was wanderer, or he used to live nomadic life. What's the meaning of nomadic? The one who keep on shifting from one place to another. They used to eat raw food, raw vegetables first of all, and slowly they started growing crops. Okay, and slowly they started growing crops. In this way we can say that the first time the agriculture came into existence. Okay, so first of all, the early men used to live a wanderer and a nomadic life, and slowly they learned to grow crops and they started doing agriculture. Okay, now as I told you, like everybody, everything, every living thing depends upon the plants for their food. Okay, so what has to be done to get new better crops, more food? You know, actually our population ranks second in the world. Just imagine, with so huge population, it's so difficult if the crop production is not good, if the crop which we are getting, the food which we have is not good, is not enough. Okay, so scientists keep on doing some researches, or I can say trying to bring some revolution in the field of the agriculture. Okay, now say for example, first can be the green revolution. Now what's the meaning of green revolution? The food grain, okay, the food grain was increased. Means total focus was given that how the food grain can be increased. Okay, this is known as what? Green revolution. Like total emphasis was given on how the food grains, the management of the food, how the total focus was given that how the food, the production of the grains could be increased. Okay, now second can be blue revolution. Yeah, I can understand, like it is not related with our this agriculture, but still, production of fish was focus, like new techniques, new experiments, new research program was conducted that how the production of fishes can be increased. Now third is white revolution. Okay, now what is the meaning of white revolution? The production of, it deals with the production of milk. Okay, it deals with the production of the milk. Now yellow revolution is what? The production of all seeds was focused on, okay, and under trial is golden revolution and this one is for the production of pulses. Okay, what I mean to explain is that just for the sake to give the proper food, more enough food to the population of India and to give better food, scientists keep on researching, keep on bringing some new things, okay, so that the quality as well as the quantity of the food can be improved. Say for example, when we talk about green revolution, more focus was given on the how the food grain, the production of food grain can be increased, okay. Now second is brew revolution, which includes the production of the fishes, and like how the production of fishes can be increased. Similarly, white revolution, a very famous revolution, okay, it deals with all the how the production of milk can be increased, okay, how milk products, dairy products can be focused on, can be increased, production can be increased. Then yellow, all seeds, which are the all seeds, like say sunflower, soya bean, mustard, how the production of these seeds can be increased so that the production of oil, so that the production of the oil can increase, okay. Now golden is all about pulses, it is under trial, like how the pulses, the production of the pulses can be increased. So scientists keep on doing certain experiments to bring the things as a revolution. Now I use the term agriculture, okay, I said agriculture. Now what is the meaning of agriculture? How can we define the agriculture? So what is agriculture? The process of growing crops on a large scale is known as agriculture. Okay, so now the whole chapter will be focused on the agriculture. What is agriculture? The process of growing crops on a large scale is known as agriculture. That means when the crops are grown on the large scale, huge quantity, then it is known as what? Agriculture. Now before starting with the agriculture, I would just like to inform you also about the type, or we can say the branches of agriculture, okay. So like, you know why I'm telling this, like when we are reading agriculture also we should know like what can be the different branches, okay. So first of all is horticulture, okay. Now what is the meaning of horticulture? It is the branch of agriculture which deals, okay, with the production and the management, okay, deals with the production it deals with the it is a branch of agriculture it is a branch of agriculture which deals with what it deals with the production and management of fruits and flowers. Now I'm telling about the what is agriculture. We all know the process of growing crops on a large scale is known as agriculture. Now I'm talking about the branches of agriculture. So to start with, the first is horticulture. You all might have heard somewhere horticulture, it is the branch of agriculture which deals with the production and management of fruits and flowers. Now fruits were obviously in the orchards and flowers were in the gardens, okay. So this is a branch which deals with the fruits and flowers are very important branch of agriculture. Now second is olericulture. Now this olericulture, it deals with the production and management of vegetables. It deals with the production and the management of the vegetables. Now third one is aquaculture. Now third one is aquaculture, means it deals with the aquatic plants. Means all the development and the management of the aquatic plants and even animals also. Now fourth one is agronomy. Now fourth one is agronomy. It deals with the development, management of the crops and soil. So the branches of agriculture, there are few more branches, but this one is quite enough for you all. So horticulture, it deals with the production of fruits and flowers. Olericulture, it deals with the production and management of vegetables. Aquaculture means it deals with it, one or the other way, the development, the more production of the aquatic plants and other animals also. Now agronomy, it deals how to manage the management of crops and the better, like how the quality of the soil can be improved. All these things are dealt with agronomy. Just have a glance. Olimen was a wanderer. He was a nomadic. He used to lead a rather nomadic life. Then somehow he learned to grow the crops, and so the agriculture came into existence. Then scientists started with certain revolutions so that the crop productions, or one particular crop, can increase. Green, food grains, blue, fish, white as a color, as I suggest, milk, yellow with the oil seeds, golden with the pulses. Now the next was agriculture. What is agriculture? To grow the, or the process of growing crops on a large scale is known as agriculture. These are the branches of agriculture: horticulture, olericulture, aquaculture and agronomy. So just now we have discussed about this. So now I am seeing one word over here, crops. Now when I say crops, what is exactly the meaning of crop is? So just we will have a look upon what the crops are. So when we say crops, like see, crops can be of many types.